You know, I think you've finally found your calling, Carly. Con artist.
Oh, come on, Paul. That's a little too easy.
Oh, come on. You come waltzing in here. You know, I was in that courtroom, too. I saw the photos. Remember, I was there when Craig tried to finagle you onto the payroll. You know, that's how we met. Craig Montgomery's made it his life's work to find you a job. And now I'm supposed to trust you and the intruder, a supermarket tabloid that makes his money off of other people's misery. Come on. You think I just fell off the turnip truck?
It landed right on your head.
Oh,
I mean, that's what happened, right? You just got here, so you don't know who you can trust?
Well, sometimes it's enough to know who to avoid.
If the whole world thinks that Craig Montgomery and I are an item, it's because of you. It's because you gave those pictures to the DA. You told the press that I was his whore. That we were trying to murder Barbara together. All lies. But you didn't care, did you? You just wanted what you wanted. To get the man who married your mother and threatened your position at BRO, and it didn't matter if you hurt me in the process. So just save your holier-than-thou, okay? You have no right.
You finished?
No, I'm not. Now, I'm going to write this story about Barbara. I'm going to be fair, I'm going to be accurate, and I really would like your input. I will give you my word that no one else is going to touch this story but me and my editor.
Yeah, Craig.
Emily, I have not seen Craig in weeks.
That's too bad. You two were a very, very lovely couple.
You know, your mother is a very independent woman. You keep making decisions for her. She's gonna find somebody else to fetch your tea.
Okay, you've made your pitch. I've listened. And now you get out. You fetch your kid and you get out of this house.
Okay. We're going, honey. But just remember something. Sooner or later, I'm gonna see Barbara. And she's gonna want in on this.
No, she won't. She doesn't read The Intruder. And besides, she's gonna be too busy with the spring collection.
Sweetie, what do you have there? Huh? Have you been drawing?
Wait, those are mine. Those are mine. Here.
No, Paul. These,
the preliminary sketches. They're preliminary sketches.
They're not. It's obvious. These are your mother's ideas, aren't they? This is her spring line.
Shh. You happy now? You got your scoop.
I had no idea.
Neither did I. But Craig did.
You can't use those, Paul. You know that, right? They
stink. I know.
She's cobbled together designs from the past three seasons.
Carly, you don't have to tell me what's wrong with them. I know.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. But if you print one word about these sketches...
No. No, I wouldn't.
Oh, come on, Carly. That's why you're here. That's why Craig sent you. For leverage.
Leverage? Look, I've been in Chicago for the last few days. So if something's happened...
There was a hearing. Long story short, the worldwide stock. You know, the ones that he bought with the stolen money from BRO? He and Barbara have to share it. And he wants to buy Barbara's half. And he knows the only way he can do it is if BRO fails. So that's why he sends you... his dear girlfriend
down here
to get the scoop and find out what's happening.
I swear to you, I had no idea.
Well, either you are a terrific liar, or Craig Montgomery has used you once again. You know something? It doesn't even matter. These could be great designs, and if that's what you wrote, he would throw it away and print a smear job.
No, not with my name on it. Come on, sweetie, let's go. I'm not gonna do the story.
I thought it was your job.
Well. That's too bad.
What about Emily?
I don't know. I'll tell her that Barbara's unavailable. She's out of the country, something. Come on, sweetie, let's go see Daddy, okay?
And what about Craig?
Oh, I'm gonna deal with Craig, believe me.
Give me one reason to trust you, Carly.
You have no choice.